Well, hello everyone. This is Mitchell Mote from the University of Tennessee and the Tennessee State University Extension Program, bringing you episode number 2 of our Yard Smart series. Today, our topic of discussion is, what do I set it on? And we're going to be, for the next few minutes, discussing how to figure out what setting to use on your spreader to apply the desired amount of stuff to your lawn area. I would like to point out that any brands, any brand names that are shown during this talk are simply for the sake of illustration only, and the use of a brand or the visualization of the picture of a brand should not be viewed as a recommendation of that brand, nor should it be viewed as a condemnation of that brand. It's just there strictly for illustration only. So our story opens today, and we've either got the world's greatest lawn guy or the world's greatest lawn lady. They wake up on Saturday morning. It's a nice morning, and it's going to be the perfect day to apply fertilizer to their home lawn because they know that a home lawn benefits from a good fertility program. It helps to make the plants, provide the plants with the right amount of nutrients at the right time that will allow that plant to achieve, you know, its genetic potential in terms of color and growth rate and hardiness and strength, et cetera. So they're going to make the trip down to the garden center to purchase that fertilizer and make that feeding before the day is over with. So they get ready, they go down to the garden center and they peruse all of the fertilizer offerings that the garden center has, and there's quite a few down there. And so after looking everything over pretty closely, they purchase this particular bag of fertilizer. And we can see from looking at the label that it is a 30-0-10 analysis fertilizer. And just as a reminder, what do those numbers represent? Always listed in this order on a bag of fertilizer, those three numbers represent nitrogen. In this case, 30% nitrogen. The next number would represent phosphorus. So this particular fertilizer has no phosphorus, zero phosphorus. And the third number represents potassium. So this fertilizer has 10% potassium. So there's 30% nitrogen, no phosphorus, and 10% potassium in this 50-pound bag of fertilizer material. So our hero, they make the purchase and they head back home. And when they get home and change into the appropriate lawn care clothes, it occurs to them that there are two questions that they need to determine the answer to before they can properly make this fertilizer application to their lawn. Question number one is, how much of this stuff do I need to put on my yard? How much of this 30-0-10 fertilizer in this 50-pound bag am I going to use to fertilize my yard? And number two is, what do I set the spreader on in order for me to make that correct application? So there's some information that our hero has to have before they can answer these questions. So what is that information? What are the facts, if you will, that this person needs to know in order to answer these questions? Well, first of all, they need to know the size of the yard area to be fertilized, and preferably in square feet. So they need area in square feet, the treatment area in square feet. That's important. They also need to know what is the application rate of that fertilizer product per unit of area, or in this case, how many pounds of the product should they be applying for every 1,000 square feet. That's the application rate. And finally, what spreader setting would they set their spreader on to deliver that application rate? So we know now what what has to be answered. So how do you arrive at the answers to those questions? Well, determining the size of the yard area can be a fairly straightforward process. I mean, number one, you can measure it. You know, you can pace it off. You can use a measuring wheel. You can use a tape measure. Just some way to accurately take the physical measurements of the yard, and then just using math, calculate it. If you've got a square yard or a rectangular shaped yard, it's pretty simple. Length times width equals area in square feet. If you've got a more odd shaped area, then, you know, there are other formulas you can use. We're not going to have a math lesson right here today, but just understand that there are ways to calculate the area by using different measuring tools, or there are some online calculation tools available, such as this one we see shown here in this example. And this is from a sod solution company. The Sod Solutions is the name of the company where you can, you know, purchase sod, and they've got a square footage calculator to help you do that. But there are lots of other places besides this particular site that will allow you to do that. So long as you can identify the corners of the property in question from aerial photograph, you can use one of these online square footage calculators. So in this instance, you can see our example area. It's outlined in the blue shade, and you can see the kind of greenish orange or the greenish yellow corners there. So that defines the area that we're going to be looking at. And if we look over here on this side of the screen, on the left side of the screen, we can see that the area of this, or the size of this shaded area in terms of square feet, is 15,263 square feet. So our example area today is going to be 15,263 square feet. So we've determined how large the area is, what the size of the treated area is going to be. Now we need to know what the application rate of the fertilizer product is. And most every product is going to give you, you know, some directions as to how much of this product to apply per unit of area. And we look at this bag right on the front cover of the bag. We see down at the bottom, what's outlined in red, it says this 50-pound bag covers up to 18,750 square feet. Okay, well, so we know it has to go out at some rate in order to equal that. Okay, so what is that rate per 1,000 square feet? It's pretty simple to figure out. Again, just a real simple little calculation. Our quantity of fertilizer is 50 pounds. So we divide this 50-pound bag by the area it will treat in the area it will treat expressed in the number of 1,000 square foot units. So 18,750 square feet, that equals 18.75 thousand square foot units. So 50 pounds divided by 18.75 tells us that the application rate is 2.67 pounds, almost 2 3/4 pounds of this product per 1,000 square feet. So how much nutrient does that actually apply out there? That's how many pounds of fertilizer, but pounds of fertilizer does not necessarily equal pounds of nutrient. So to tell us that, we can take our 2.67 pounds of fertilizer applied per 1,000 square foot unit, okay, 2.67 pounds, and our example yard measured out to be 15,263 square feet. So that comes to 15.263,000 square foot units, okay, so 2.67 times 15.263 equals 40.75 pounds of fertilizer to fertilize our example yard. So it's not going to take the entire bag, this 50-pound bag of fertilizer, to fertilize our 15,263 square foot example yard. So now we figured out the size of the area that we're going to treat. We figured out what the application rate is. The next thing is to determine what spreader setting to use. One point I want to make, though, before we get away from this slide. So the amount of nutrient that we put out there is 2.67 pounds times 30% nitrogen. That tells us that we're putting out there 0.8 pounds, okay, 0.8 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot. Just as a rule of thumb, would suggest to you that you not apply more than 1 pound of actual nitrogen per 1,000 square feet. So the pounds of fertilizer is one thing, the pound of nutrient is another. So in the first case, we calculated how many pounds of fertilizer we're going to put over each 1,000 square foot area. And in the second example here, that we're figuring out how many pounds of actual nutrient we're applying. This, we use nitrogen as an example. So 2.67 pounds per 1,000 feet times the percentage of nitrogen, which is 30%, tells us then that we're putting out 0.8 pounds, okay, almost, or 0.8 of a pound of nitrogen for every 1,000 square feet. And since our potash is, you know, a third of what the nitrogen rate is, then we know that we're putting out only a third as much, you know, probably just a shade over 0.2 pounds of potash per 1,000 feet compared to 0.8 pounds of nitrogen. And just as a rule of thumb for future reference, it's our recommendation to you that when you apply nitrogen, that you apply no more than 1 pound of nitrogen per 1,000 square foot at a single application. So what rate or what spreader setting now do we set our spreader on in order to deliver that desired rate of product? Well, I don't know. We've got to figure that out, or you got to figure that out. And you do that through a process called calibration. Now, every spreader out there, be it a drop spreader or a broadcast spreader, we've got examples of both kinds listed here, all have some sort of a metering device on them. And you can see different metering devices shown right here. These devices all have a scale, and the scale is expressed, okay, in either in terms of numbers or letters. And if it's a number scale, the higher the number, okay, the greater the application rate typically is. And if it's an alphabetical scale, then the higher up, the further down the alphabet you go, the greater the application rate is, because every one of these scales, okay, is attached to an opening or corresponds to an opening in the hopper spreader, or excuse me, in the hopper of the spreader, or the box that you pour the fertilizer material into on the spreader. So the bigger the number that you set on your scale, the bigger that hole is going to open up down in the bottom of the hopper and allow more material to flow out of it. So the bigger the number, the higher the letter, then the greater the application rate, because that scale relates directly to how large that opening is going to be in the hopper of the fertilizer spreader. So to calculate what number to use or what letter to use to set this scale on, we calibrate the spreader. And there's more than one way to do most everything, and there's certainly more than one way to calibrate a broadcast spreader. I want to show you one example. Now, in this example, the first thing that we're going to do is determine what the spread width of that spreader is. You know, at any given walking speed, at any given setting, that fertilizer spreader will only throw that material, you know, so far. And we want to determine what that spread width is. So what we've done here is we've just taken some styrofoam food trays, and we spread an equal number of those out on either side of the spreader. And what we're going to do then is this young lady is going to, drive the spreader, if you will. She's going to push the spreader, you know, through or across the lawn and allow the material to flow out, and going to use those trays as catch pans to see how far out on either side of the spreader it does apply material. So then we can measure that and determine what the spread width is. So she sets it, she drives through it, and she determines that the spread width here, after we go back and look and see, you know, how many trays out the thing spread, we counted and we saw that the spreader put fertilizer in the fourth tray, okay, the fourth tray from center on each side. Now the little rocks in here are these are lightweight styrofoam trays. We place those rocks there just to keep them from blowing away. So we put our tape measure at the fourth tray on the left side. As we're looking here, we stretch it across to the fourth tray on the right side, because that's how far we caught material. Okay, and that tells us that our spread width for that particular spreader is 8 feet. Now, a thing to keep in mind when you're using a broadcast spreader like this, or any spreader, is that walking speed does influence the spread width. The faster you walk, the wider it will be up to a point. The slower you walk, the more narrow it will be. So you want to use a consistent walking speed so you maintain a consistent spread width. All right, so we figure out that our spread width is 8 feet. Next, we want to divide that 1,000, or we divide 1,000 by our spread width. Okay, so we divide 1,000 and our spread width is 8, and that gives us 125. And what is 125? Well, 125 is what we call our calibration course length. Because based on the spread width, which in this case was 8 feet, the distance that this spreader must travel to cover 1,000 square feet is 125 feet, because 8 times 125 is 1,000. So we can drive this spreader, which spreads an 8-foot wide swath of fertilizer, which delivers that widest spread of fertilizer, over 125 feet, and we will have physically covered 1,000 square feet. So we're going to measure and mark off our 125-foot-long calibration course length in this case, okay, is 125 feet. Then we're going to put a known weight of product in the spreader. So we use just a spring scale. We weigh, put some fertilizer in a bucket. We weigh it. And then we put that over into the spreader. And it looks like we weighed about 15 pounds of fertilizer. And we place that fertilizer over into our spreader. And then we choose a spreader setting. Okay, we've got to start somewhere on here. And so we just choose a setting on the spreader. In this example, we chose I. So we set the spreader scale on I. And so then, once it's all set, then you drive the course, or you drive the spreader across the length of the course with the spreader open, delivering the fertilizer. And then at the end of the course, so that's what she's doing right here, she's spreading the fertilizer over this 125-foot length. And then once she's finished that, she shuts the spreader off, and then we weigh the remaining product, or the product that remained in the spreader. Okay, so here we have material left in the spreader. We dumped it back out in the bucket. We weighed that, and it looks like that weighed in at about 9 pounds. We started then, okay, with a weight that we measured. We recorded that weight, and then we got an ending weight. So the difference between the starting weight and the ending weight is the application rate of that spreader at that particular setting for that particular walking speed. So in this example, we started with 15 pounds. We had 9 pounds left over. So that means that there was a difference of 6 pounds. And so 6 pounds was the application rate of this broadcast spreader at the setting I. Okay. So as long as you're using that fertilizer material and you set that spreader at I and you walk at a consistent speed that you used in this example, then you're going to put out about 6 pounds of that product for every 1,000 square feet. Well, what if you didn't need, you know, in our previous example, we only needed 2.67 pounds. Okay, in that case, that tells you you got it set too high. So you got to back that number off. So you're going to go down the scale. You're going to decrease the number or the letter on the scale. So by doing that, you're going to decrease the opening, the size of the opening hole in the bottom of the hopper, and you're going to decrease the application rate. And after you do that, then you test it again. Move it over another 125-foot course length or however long it needs to be for your particular spreader. And calculate it until you come up with the desired application rate. Then you make a note of that so that you'll have it for future reference. You'll know that, you know, anytime that you're going to spread this material, you need to set your spreader at whatever it worked out to be in order to get that desired application rate. Well, what if you don't use a broadcast spreader? What if you use a drop spreader instead? Well, you could use the same process to calibrate this drop spreader as we use to calibrate the broadcast spreader. But because this drop spreader has a very narrow width of application, because it only drops the material in the openings between those two wheels. That being the case, you might have to have a very long calibration course length in order to get 1,000 feet. So another way to do that, so it doesn't take quite such a long area, is to use this method. And this method can be used for a drop or broadcast spreader, either one. But you measure and mark off 1,000 square feet. So you could measure and mark off a 50 foot by 20 foot area. Then you place a known weight of the desired product in the spreader. You select a spreader setting. You spread that product over the area, then you weigh the material left in the hopper, and the difference between the beginning and the ending weights is the application rate per 1,000 square foot for that product at that setting. So in this example, we weighed in our material here using the drop spreader. It came up to 21 pounds. We put that over in the spreader. We set the drop spreader meter scale at 6.5, and we spread this out over our 1,000 square foot area. Then we come back and we weigh what was left over, and that comes in at 12 pounds, okay? So we started with 21 pounds. We have 12 pounds remaining. That tells us that our application rate was 9 pounds per 1,000 square feet at a setting of 6.5 for that particular material for that drop spreader. So we now know what the output rate is at 6.5. And if it's too high, we're going to adjust it down and do it again. If it's too low, we're going to adjust it up and do it again until we can get to what our desired application rate per 1,000 square foot is. And that's what there is to it. You know, that's a very simple process to go through. It's an important process to do that, because so many times folks buy fertilizer products and many products, you read on the label, it'll say, if you have this spreader, set it here to put out this rate. Very often the spreader that you have is not listed on the product. Okay. And so it's a good idea to be able, in order for you to accurately apply the correct amount of product, you need to be able to accurately calibrate your spreader. And we've just covered how to do that. Pretty simple process. I do want to thank Miss Amy Willis, my coworker, for assisting today by being the spreader driver, the spreader operator, to take these few pictures to allow us to put this talk together for you. Folks, again, my name is Mitchell Mote, and I'm one of the agents here at the Rutherford County Extension Service Office. You can reach me at 615-898-7710 during office hours, 8 to 4:30 Monday through Friday, or you can reach me via email at mmote1@utk.edu. And we're always, myself, my coworkers are always eager and anxious to talk to you to help answer any questions you might have on topics regarding horticulture, lawn care, landscape, gardening, or other agriculture-related topics. Well, folks, that's all I've got for you today. I hope you found this information useful, and I hope you'll tune in again. Until next time, this is Mitchell Mote from the University of Tennessee and Tennessee State University Extension Program saying so long.